Hi guys, how's it going? So this is day 5 of me practicing Mr. Scary by Dokken. As you see, I'm back with a different guitar. Today we are going to rock the ES Les Paul. Pretty excited for that. Haven't played that guitar in a while. Amazing guitar. Sounds mad if you play high gain stuff on it, which is actually probably not what most people would do with it, but I love it. I think it's one of the meanest sounds I've ever heard. I absolutely adore it. It is awesome. On that note, today we are going to add the next part to Mr. Scary, which is the run after basically this one. Right? So after this part, the riff starts again, but then there is a basically alternation of the riff. And this is what we're going to focus on today. We will see how it goes. I don't know, but I'm pretty excited because yesterday was absolutely crazy. Day 4 was the first day I was able to actually play over the record. And I wasn't... I wasn't expecting that to happen because I thought it would take me way longer to get all the parts and all the specialties nailed that are needed to make it sound right. And that was luckily not the case. And therefore we can focus on the alternation of the riff today. And with that being said, let's just dive right in. Okay, so just to refresh our minds here, this is the song we're talking about. And this is the part we are going to focus on today. And as I said, we will have to figure it out. I don't know how it goes. We will see. And on that note, let's just dive right in. So just a quick refresher. This is what we have as of now. Right, so yeah, this is what we have as of now. As you see, it goes better by the day. This is especially very interesting because this guitar has a way different action than the guitar I played on the last videos, and therefore it is basically twice as nice of a surprise that we can get it done on this guitar as well, and maybe even cleaner. But I'm not sure if it is because of the guitar. This guitar plays really well, but the action is slightly higher. But maybe I tweak the action on the other guitar as well, but we will see how it goes. I haven't touched the other guitar today, so I don't know if I'm able to play it even better on the red guitar than I'm able to on this guitar, but I don't know, we will see. So let's speed it up a bit and see where we are. So right now, I'm actually focusing on my picking hand. I'm focusing heavily on keeping my picking hand as loose as possible. And it is working great for me. It is working wonders. It is awesome. And it also contributes to me being less tired of playing the riff and, yeah, being able to play it for a sustained amount of time. Yes, on that note, let's check out the new part of the song. So basically, the beginning is this. And then comes I think he does a vibrato here. Okay, this is very doable. As you saw, the second part of the new riff is actually the second part of the first riff as well. And that is obviously very nice because that makes it easier. Let's figure out what is going on here. Something is missing here. I know he does a hammer-on pull-off type of thing. I have seen it in his video. To play at all, you basically have to do a hammer-on pull-off with your pinky finger. So first you do the hammer-on and then you do the pull-off. Also mute after every single note. So basically I'm not playing. But I play. So not. Way harder to do because you have to lift your finger after every note you played, ever so slightly, just so that the string stops ringing and is muted. I don't know if I've ever played something where I wanted or needed to mute every note from ringing out. So I'm actually pretty surprised that it is working so well for me. I think it was the best idea for me to just dive right into Mr. Scary, because that is something, that is a riff and a song I always wanted to play, but I knew it would be very hard for me to pull it off. And I think challenging myself with this and basically reaching for the stars was groundbreaking for my guitar skills. I think I reached the next level, basically. So that is awesome. I'm super stoked. Sorry. Actually, the tab I have in front of me on my screen says it is played differently than I play it, but I don't know if I want to change that now, because I love the way I play it. So basically the tab says you should play that part like this. Instead of, but I think I actually like my version better. I prefer my version, so I'm keeping my version. A transitional part in between that, which I just saw in the tabs, which should be like, we'll be right back. let's listen to the song again, because I don't really understand what the tab is telling me here. Ah. Okay, so it is basically guitar, so awesome, so awesome. Anyways, let's keep on playing. That is very funny, because actually, if you watch my day one and I think even day two video, I played basically the intro riff like a consolidation of the original first riff and the original second riff, which is very interesting, because what I played, because I didn't want to focus on the crazy fast alternate picking and learning the string skipping at the same time. Therefore, I transposed the riff from this to this. And if we now look at the part that we learned today, it is basically what I played on the first two videos, but not because I wanted to merge the second part with the first one, but because I wanted to find an easier version to play the intro riff, so I didn't want to basically start with the string skipping right from the beginning. So therefore I transposed from the third string to the from the fourth to the fifth string, and yeah, did it like this, which is very, very funny that it is now actually in the song itself, but in the second part of the riff. We'll be right back. this is very, very important. I'm focusing on the palm muting technique here because we don't want it to sound like this. We want it to sound like this. Not. But. See, because we are focusing so much on our technique here, on the perfect picking technique and on the perfect muting technique on the bridge, which is the palm muting, and also on the perfect finger, I don't even know how this is called, like a finger string type of muting technique, we get an extremely clean sound, even though extremely clear note, even though we have a crazy overdriven sound. Actually, it's not crazy overdriven, especially not with this guitar, because it has actually low output humbuckers, but it is still a very overdriven sound, but we can hear every note crystal clear, and that is because of that very very nice muting technique that I actually developed over time, and that is now benefiting me here very well. But basically before learning this riff, which is actually from Buckethead, before learning this riff, like, my alternate picking was really, really not that great, especially not compared to my downstroke abilities, which is this. Yeah, basically, this is my downstroke abilities, and before learning that song from Buckethead, I can't recall the name, unfortunately. It is like, if you search for Buckethead delay trick or Buckethead delay song, let me actually pull it up for you so that you can hear it, because that song is insane. He did a delay trick with this song and it sounded insane. Yeah, it is Big Sur Moon, and it sounds like this. Insane, right? Insane. And that is basically that is that riff. Actually, no, this is a different song. What? What is this song? I don't know. It is some kind of Buckethead song. And before learning that song, I actually struggled a lot with my alternate picking, because for some kind of reason, I never really practiced it. And it came so natural to me to just play everything in downstrokes. And I'm actually very happy about that, because now I can do both. And I focused heavily on the downstrokes, and therefore I think I developed a really great muting and rhythm technique. But the thing is, before playing that Bucket Head track, and now this is the basically second riff I'm... So the... The Mr. Scary riff is the second riff I really practice using alternate picking. And therefore I'm extremely stoked about my progress, because the thing is, it is only my basically my second real learning session for alternate picking, which is very nice. But yeah, I played that Buckethead song a lot. I played that song like, I don't even know how many times. It was a crazy amount of times. But yeah, let's play it again. I need to get faster with this part here to tie it together. Now, let's try to play Mr. Scary over the song. Okay. Okay, I'm not there yet, I'm not there yet. I mean, I can just wing it basically and just keep on playing even though I make mistakes, which is awesome. And this is one of my biggest takeaways actually when playing the guitar. Try to just keep on playing. Whatever, basically whatever takes, whatever happens, happens. Try to develop the skill of continue playing even though you mess up. If you can sustain your playing and you mess up, it is half as bad. It is actually barely noticeable for people who would not play the guitar. If you can really get back to it, like within a second, you just play one wrong note, like whatever, whatever. As long as you don't basically miss the beat and then, basically have to start all over again. That would obviously be not very good. But if you just miss one note or play a wrong note, like whatever. So therefore, insanely good skill to have is just to try to keep playing whatever takes. And this is a technique that I used heavily in the first, I don't know, I think it was day four video or something of me trying to learn Mr. Scary. I focused on that a lot. Like, whatever happened, I just kept playing. And I think that enabled me to make that much progress in such a short amount of time. On that note, let's get a click track going. Let's try like 150 and try to play the new section, the second part. Or basically the second riff, I should say, not the second part. Second part is what I named this part. First, like I said second part a lot in the last videos, but in the first video, the second part was that part. And I think from video 4 on, the second part was that part. And now I'm referring to that as the second part. But whatever it is, whatever part it is basically riff 2 part 1. And riff 2 part 2 is this. Yeah, on that note, click track 150. Let's speed it up a notch. Let's go to 165. Strange kind of reason, 165 was actually easier for me than 150. And this is something I noticed a lot. Like, there are riffs and licks that I can play fast, but I cannot play them slow. I just cannot play them slow. It doesn't work. And if I try to, usually the case is that I can't remember how to play them. Like, it is so incorporated by the time I play them fast, it is so in my muscle memory that when I play them slow, the muscle memory doesn't work. And therefore, I cannot play the licks again because I don't remember the licks actually. Just my muscle memory remembers the licks, which is very interesting. Let's go to 169. Okay, let's speed it up. Just for the sake of it, let's shoot for the moon here, 180. Like, I think 210, 215 was the original one. Guys, remember, this is day 5 of me practicing this, and the day before yesterday I was not even able to play the riff at full speed. So that really makes me proud. So of course there are a few mess ups here and there. This is not clean on full speed, but we are actually getting there. We are getting closer. I just have to keep on doing the same thing I did in the last videos, and we will get there very soon. So on that note, let's try the second part at, like, let's say 187. Actually, let's not do the second part with the click track. I will do this in the next next video I'm going to make. For now, let's just play it without a click track. We'll be right back. one thing I'm noticing, that my pinky is not strong enough to do this for a long period of time. I can really feel my hand cramping up, and not just muscle fatigue, but more like a, like, I don't know how it's called, like, yeah, sorry guys, I don't know, like, not fatigue in a good way, basically. Very, very, very crampy, very hard to even make a fist right now. So I should probably slow down a little bit with that pinky trick, because it feels like I've done a bicep curls with my pinky, and I don't know if that is a good thing, because I don't want to get a huge pinky. Maybe, I don't know, maybe let's just slow down a little bit on the hammer on and pull offs with the pinky finger, and work our way up there within the next lessons. Within the next practice sessions, excuse me. I guess, guys, on that note, I will wrap it up for today's video, because I have to give my hands and allow my hands to get some rest too, because otherwise I'm not able to continue this for very long, and I don't want that. Like, if you play a lot of guitar, always remember to take frequent breaks. Like, just take, if you cannot and want not, take days off, which is basically me. I hate it when I'm really in the zone of getting better at playing guitar. I cannot stop. I have to play every single day. On the video yesterday, I actually said that I'm probably that I should take a break today, and that I'm probably not gonna take a break today. I basically said I should take a break, but probably I'm not going to take a break. And yeah, here we are, not taking a break. So therefore, I will just keep the videos a little bit shorter and not play as long, because I would rather just play a little bit every single day and not lose that momentum than playing for hours every single day, every other day, excuse me. Yeah, on that note, I will wrap it up. I will see you in the next one. Have a nice day. Bye-bye. Peace out.